bust up.
Okay, guys, I'm going to do a little walk around on my buddy's DeSoto. I think I've told this story before, but James is the guy that sold me my 63 Bettie E-Type Jag. And the reason was because he had found this car, which his mother bought brand new from the Chrysler dealer in town when he was a little boy. And he found it in a garage, in a barn. Some old guy in their hometown had kept it for 50 years. So he's restored it. Look at this thing. Isn't this pretty? He's done such a nice job.
It's fine, yeah.
But it's fun. Say hi, James.
What?
Say hi.
Oh, hi.
This is the guy who owned my Jag originally. Now he owns this gorgeous 49?
49 DeSoto.
DeSoto. Isn't this incredible?
Yeah, I traded the E-Type for this.
Isn't this incredible? God. You got to see this interior.
You had the mirror?
Look at this fabric.
I do.
This looks a lot like Greg's... Carmen Ghia, you know, this sort of herringbone, or no, it's a square weave, and then this beautiful leather or leatherette in the green and tan just looks so nice together. And here's the look at the dashboard. It's mint. Look at these instruments, man. They're just so vintage, so cute. Look at this. Look at the radio grill. It's like stainless steel mesh through these cutouts. That's so cool. Fluid drive automatic. No, it's a three speed, like a three on the tree.
Exact diameter.
Doesn't that look great? Look at the chrome up here. You know, this whole, just the way things were put together, right? These little countersunk stainless Phillips head screws that are holding these panel caps in place and stuff. It's just so thick. And these cars are heavy. This cover, look at how nicely made this is with the stitching. He really knows how to do it right. You know.
Probably.
It looks great. He told me he doesn't have the convertible top made yet. Because there's only a couple of guys on Earth who can actually hand make a top. There's no patterns for this car. This car was only made 1 year. And so he's going to have to have it handmade, hand-stitched by somebody who knows what they're doing. You know, look at the door locks, you know, these old little key covers. It's so cute. It's just stuff that takes you back to when you were a kid, you know, and the way cars looked back then. There's felt in here, not rubber.
This one has an independent frame.
Yeah, I mean, we literally...
So he's remaking these mounts here for the mirrors. They were, like, rotted, and so he had to do some work to rethread the hole in there to get the mirror body to bolt back on.
Rigged up.
And this green, I'm sure my camera's not going to do it justice, but when he drove up here in the sunshine, this green was just... unbelievable. It's a beautiful metallic, very, very fine, small particle metallic.
And
this is all the original chrome. It's been replated or polished, depending on whether it was chrome or stainless steel. And look at the DeSoto. Is this an explorer? Like he was a Spanish conquistador, I think, DeSoto. And the plastic covering on it's all cracked and split, but he said there just isn't any place to buy replacements. There's one set that he found. The guy wants $600 for the pair of plastic covers, so I guess that's not going to happen anytime soon. So DeSoto Custom Convertible. Isn't that pretty? Oh, he opened the trunk. Let's check this out.
Basic. So the pump's under there for the top. And there was a dead spot to the left of the tire there, in the back there, and that's where I put that's where the Midland Ross power brake booster is. And I put a vacuum tank directly behind the seat, back seat, you know, for the booster.
So
you got four or five extra stops at the end.
James, I'm pretty disappointed in the condition of this brace now.
I know, it hasn't. Yeah, I just cleaned it and put it on. That's original.
No.
It's going to cost you points.
No. You got to clean that up.
You know what took me forever? Was finding one of these. One was missing. And this one's only in so-so shape, the reflector.
Oh, yeah.
See, there's one that's in perfect shape, and there's one that's in so-so
shape.
Yep. And I've been hunting and hunting. Plymouth used round ones. Chrysler used round ones. Dodge didn't use them. And only DeSoto in 49 only. 50, they changed it.
Nice.
And there was only 6 months production in 49.
So buy a round one and mill it to an oval. Come on, buddy.
Problem is, it's plastic, and the way it's designed, you never get it in there.
Yeah, I hear you.
What a pain in the...
No, I hear you. I bought the round reflectors for the back of the E-Type. You know, the ones that go in the rear housing? Uh-huh. The new ones they sell are too big. They don't fit. So I had to mill down.
Mill the housing to fit the...
No, I didn't mill the housing. I took the plastic and milled it down.
The other thing that killed me is
there
this
are two
size...
or three different variations of those things. Yeah. Because the pattern of the...
The writing and everything is wider, too.
Yeah, but there are two or three different ones, and you have to have the right one.
Well, I'm sure I got the wrong one, but I ordered it for a Series 1 Jag E-Type, but it didn't come out
right. You see the stainless bead strip?
Yeah.
Nobody makes it. It doesn't exist.
Hey, Jaguar makes this.
But try bending a... It's a double
twist.
One had gotten whacked at some point.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And that's the best I could get it.
Well, that looks pretty good.
And I've been looking and looking and looking, but what was a real bitch is it's got... You know, the tail about like this, and it was like that kind of semi-vulcanized rubber. And, of course, half of it had torn out and rotted.
Yep.
How do you get the stuff? So it took Don and I sat there for like 2 weeks trying to figure out. What I finally did is I made a tool out of nylon, like a little nylon wedge. And I went through and tapped it and spread the whole thing open and then cleaned out. I had to use a Dremel with little balls on the inside to get all the stuff out, clean
and then
it.
The rubber out.
Okay. You know what I used to put it back together? This was just dumb luck. I was flipping through. I don't know how I got on their mailing list, but I got a catalog from Max. They do all the Mallet parts and early Ford stuff. Mm-hmm.